Hi, it's time for another math easy solution. Today I'm going to go over another random topic, and this one's on using Audacity for background noise removal as well as Camtasia video editing to basically merge the new audio with the video. So let's just keep going further. So topics to cover: background noise, look at Audacity free audio editing software, and then importing MP4 and MPM and M4A audio files, how they require extra library download, and then go over noise reduction with the Audacity software, and then Amplify sound removal and volume booster. Go over an important note on Audacity and large file usage, as well as going further into MES Audacity tips and recommendations, and also get noise canceling headphones. Very handy for detecting background noise. I'll show how to merge audio and video in Camtasia video editing software. Alright, so let's look at some background noise, or some background on the background noise and why I'm making this video. So when I record videos, unfortunately there is some background noise either from my refrigerator or even computer or computers themselves, such as my tablet and PC and so on. And my older videos are examples of this. If you want to hurt your ears, try my earlier videos. Anyways, going further. Recently, I've tried to improve my audio by getting a better microphone and even some low-level noise-canceling setups, but still the background noise persists. And here, one way around that is using Audacity free audio editing software. So since at the moment I can't readily remove the background noise, I found some good audio editing techniques with the Audacity free audio editing software. You can go download it here at audacityteam.org. And just note, I'm currently using version 2.3.2. Also a note before I go and show how to use it. Importing MP4 and slash M4A audio files requires extra library download, So yes, with MP4, I believe that's the audio file in it. And when you import it inside, it converts or just uses the audio file, and that's in M4A, at least for me. Note that importing MP4 video files into Audacity automatically imports only the audio and in a M4A format, but this requires additional library downloads, and there's a link to it. And it's fairly straightforward how you download this library, and then you have to go into the preferences on Audacity and just point to that location. Anyways, going further, so once you've done that, noise reduction. So to remove background noise in Audacity, I mainly use the noise reduction option in the effect tab and with the following settings. Although the noise reduction in dB or decibels setting, I sometimes vary to 10 dB, 10 decibels if too much of the normal audio gets removed. So here's a setting that I have. It's usually either 20 or sometimes 10 if I wanna remove less audio, or if the edited audio just remove too much of the speech and whatnot, or just the sound that you want. So you could vary it, but the sensitivity of 2 and 4 frequency bands, which I've tested out, and it seems pretty decent. So usually just one pass of the filter is needed, but may need 2 depending on your audio. And I'll get to that in a bit. So after applying this filter, I check the audio to make sure that it sounds decent, and may repeat the process on a newly edited audio, but with a new noise profile to remove, and only in the region necessary. So yes, first thing to do in this one is select a few seconds of just noise, so Audacity knows what to filter out. Then click this noise profile. And step 2 is, after you've selected that, select all the audio you want filtered, choose how much noise you want filtered out, and then click OK to reduce noise. There's a noise reduction, amount of sound you want to remove. The sensitivity is basically how much of that noise profile you selected, and how much should that be considered as noise. And then frequency smoothing or bands, it actually blends different frequencies together. So if something is similar to that noise one, then they'll just blend it, and it just shows how much of that you want to blend it. So going further, so when finished, then export in the file type you want, which is for most purposes the same for audio type you imported, which is in my case M4A. So note that the option get noise profile is needed at first select. Ensure the selection tool is selected, so this part is selected. You highlight the audio, the background noise that you want to remove. Make sure it's first you first select the audio, the highlighted audio section, and then which will be used as a type of noise to remove. So you want to remove this one's highlighted, then go to the noise profile, click it after you've highlighted it, and then it will have it selected, and you have to press noise or noise removal again, noise reduction again, and then you can start removing where you want to remove it. So yes, here I've written down what those were. So the noise reduction dB option is the amount of sound in decibels to remove. The sensitivity is how much of the sound profile would be considered as noise. The frequency smoothing bands blends frequencies similar to the noise profile you selected. And then the reduce option shows the audio after noise is removed. This button here, so you could preview click this. So this would remove the audio and then show the audio after it's removed. But then the residue shows what is removed. So you could also, it's also great to preview what is actually being removed. And if it's if you can see some audible sounds that you can make out, such as speech, then that might be because that might mean you're removing too much sound when you click the preview on the residue. So yeah, here I've written that down here. So the residue option shows the audio removed and is a good tool to preview. And then also the amplify sound removal and volume booster. For any abrupt background noise, I recommend using the amplify option to lower the sound, so you can select anything and then lower it greatly if there's like abrupt noise in the background or even in the, when you're talking, you just want to get rid of it. So you could remove it greatly with this, just minus it like that. And note that the amplify option can also be used to increase the overall volume of the entire audio file. And now before I get to editing it, I just want to make another note. So on this one here, so a note's right here, for adequate volume on most devices, I recommend editing this sound while setting the computer volume to 50%. So if I click this, let's see, this is 50%. Yeah, so I would make it 50% like that. And then using the amplify option to boost the volume until it is at a comfortable volume, just so that for most devices it'll be loud enough so that you can ensure that the volume is never too low on any device. So let's just go right ahead and see what we can do. So here I've already imported it. I'll just cancel this and throw it in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab, the first video I ever made from a math channel. This is back in 2012. Interesting. So on the Pythagorean theorem. Let's go in here. Just import it. So that's that was MP4 file. So yes, go back here. So this was an MP4 file, and now it's converted to M4A. Let's just make this zoom bigger like that. And then what you could do is, so let's play it so you could hear the background noise.
Hi, it's another math easy solution. Today we're
so yeah, you can hear that noise, especially in the beginning. Let's see the beginning. Or actually, let's go to some a section that has very little the waveform of the audio. So let's go here. So yes, very loud audio there. So again, so I've made this 50% on the computer volume. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select all just to edit with it so that it's a bit louder. Gonna let's see, this amplify and just increase everything right now. Press or preview.
Hi, it's another math easy solution.
So that's a bit loud, probably 5.
Hi, it's another math easy solution. Today we're gonna discuss.
Let's go with 4 maybe, just so it's comfortable.
Hi, it's another math.
Okay, so let's just say it's okay. So took a second to that. Yeah, so now we just increase the volume everywhere. So now we can play this better background noise. All right, so that's it. So that's a good section to check it. But also what I would do is I would check the audio.
I'd see.
I would check the audio throughout to find out which one is the most generic background noise that is that encompasses all of it, because you're going to be removing from, I'm going to be removing from all of it here.
A.
So you can just
one square and sum of the square is A times B. 2. Simple proof of. Next time on another math.
So yes, basically just click around, see what's the general noise. So this one's pretty much the same as everywhere there. And I would zoom in. Zoom in. You hold control and scroll up. And then scroll up and zoom in. Just click something here. So yeah, there's a little extra background noise there. I just want to keep it here so that there's no abrupt any other noise. Okay, so that's a bit more here. All right, so that's good. So I would click here, noise. Yes, I click the effect. Go to noise reduction, and then get noise profile, like that. All right. So now what I'm gonna do is again, now that you've selected it. So now that we have these are the options that I like, 22 and 4. This one you could vary it based on whatever you, how much noise you want to remove. Let's see, let's click residue. So click residue is good to show how much gets removed. And that sounds, basically just exactly what I showed before. And now click reduce shows the preview after it's reduced. So yes, it's pretty much gone. And you don't remove too much. Let's see how much it is with the 10. So there's still some noise there. So 15. There's still a tiny bit. Let's go up at 20. But yeah, you could always do a lower one, and you could do it multiple times. But I like, so try to minimize how many times you run it through. So I think this is good. So that's 20. So now I want to do, just click all of it here. Go to effect again. So 22. And then, so we've already had the profile selected. Now I click residue just to see the beginning, because this goes from the beginning. And you can hear, let's see if you can make out any audio. So that's when I'm talking now. So that sounds like it's a good removal, because there isn't any audible sound, audible words you can make out, but it's showing that it's removing. And then here's a preview.
Hi, it's another math easy solution. Today we're going to discuss the Pythagorean.
So yes, that sounds pretty good. Let's just click OK. And it takes a few seconds. But if you had a longer video, it might take minutes if you ever, like when I had like 30 minutes or plus or... I know I had like a couple hours that was editing. So if you're doing hours of editing, it might take like 20 minutes, 10 to 20 minutes. And that's at that point, I recommend breaking up into segments, as well as segments is better, because different segments might have different, slightly different background noise. So you want to minimize how different they are. So let's say now that this is edited, what I'm going to do is to show you that at Amplify, you could also remove any abrupt noise like this. So there's some abrupt noise. It's just me, And then let's just say you want to remove that completely. So you just go here, amplify. Let's go to negative 10, for example. Preview. It's still there. Let's just go to 20. It's still a lot. Let's just go minus 40. Just remove it completely. So it's gone. So that's good. So you can just plug here.
Oh, it's another math.
Yeah, there's another extra noise. Might as well get rid of that too. But anyways, just wanted to show that. So for any abrupt noise that you see, and let's just see how the sound is here. So I'm going to highlight this. So yeah, it's very little background noise. Now you can just play it anywhere.
B plus C is, my bad, this is B squared.
There's still some background noise. So what you could do now is basically any extra noise that is slightly different.
Square.
You can go and highlight it and then remove it from any specific section. You don't want to do it too much on the ones that are decent audio because it might make the sound just a bit off, a bit squeaky or whatnot. So now that this is pretty much done, I'm just going to go and export audio, and then I'm going to click here, audio only, like that, and it is done. So let's go here. So now this is just audio only, so there's no actual thing.
Hi, it's another math easy solution. Today we're going to discuss the Pythagorean theorem and do a simple proof of it. Well, here's the Pythagorean theorem. If you have B, Pythagorean theorem.
So you can just go through it everywhere and just see it all sounds decent. So yes, this is just the audio file. So now what we'll do is go to Camtasia. Or actually, before I get to Camtasia, I'm just going to go over the notes here and then show some recommendations as well. So let's go further up here. All right, so it's just an important note on Audacity and large file usage. So keep in mind that since Audacity breaks up sound files into their sound waveform frequencies, the file size can be quite massive, especially after each progressive edit. So if you are editing a large video file, please keep in mind your computer storage capacity. If the edited audio clip during editing gets larger than the space on your computer, Audacity automatically closes. You're gonna have to find out if it recovers or not. In fact, after editing, I never save an Audacity file, but rather just the exported audio clip. And just because it's less file size to deal with. And I just try to get it right at the first go. Anyways, going further, so MES Audacity tips and recommendations. So I recommend editing each unique pre-merged audio recording clip before merging into a longer video, since likely each recording session will have its own unique background noise. But for longer videos that have already included various audio clips, I recommend editing every 30 minutes or even less, depending how long your video is, or any distinct zones. Since it is easier to select more fine-tuned and relevant background noise to remove, as well as shorter Audacity computation times. Computation times before each edit, or computation time. You wouldn't want to wait 5 to 10 minutes for the edit to finish to realize that you need to try a different noise profile or slash setting scheme. So yes, if you have smaller segments that you're editing, you can quickly check every 10 to 20 seconds as opposed to 5-10 minutes and realize you gotta change it. Anyways, I recommend first selecting a general noise profile or noise removal profile with the most generic background noise, and follow up any remaining background noise, but only in the sections of the audio they appear. And again, as I stated earlier, for adequate volume on most devices, I recommend editing the sound while setting the computer volume to 50%, and then using the Amplify option to boost the volume until it is at a comfortable volume. And also another recommendation is get noise-canceling headphones. Oftentimes, the audio may sound decent, but could be because of the environment you are listening in. For example, a video may sound decent playback on a speaker or even regular headphones, but when using decent noise-canceling headphones, the background noise becomes clear as day. Noise-canceling headphones usually involve an active microphone that picks up background noise and then blends it with the audio you are listening to, but in such a way that it's a bit out of phase, that the microphone recorded and blended background noise audio cancels out, i.e. the sound wave destructive interference. And I recommend looking at the signs of that. Yeah, so it interferes with the overall background noise. Or actually, worded better, I just put it here. In such a way that the microphone recorded audio cancels out, i.e. sound wave destructive interference with the overall background noise. So it's fascinating stuff. So the headphones I have are the Mighty Rock E7C, and you may be able to get it or similar headphones at a discount at VIPon.com. And this is just Amazon retailers. They go there and place discounts on the site in hopes of increasing sales on Amazon. So just check it out. You might be able to get the same one that I got on discount. And it's usually lesser known brand names in there. So yes, anyways, check that site out. It's pretty cool. All right, so now going further, I am merging audio and video in Camtasia. So after being satisfied with the audio over the Audacity audio editing, then I use Camtasia, which is a not free video editing software, to replace the old audio with the new. And you could use whatever you want for that, but I just have been using Camtasia for a while. So MES note, I'm currently using version 2018.0.7, build 4045, and you can go to camtasia.com, which redirects to techsmith.com. So I do this by importing the video file and then right-clicking it and selecting the separate audio and video option. So you go throw it in here, right-click, click the separate, and after which I would mute the old audio and import the new edited audio. So mute this, there's audio only. So if the audio still has some background noise and or the overall volume is too low, I sometimes apply extra but very small noise removal through Camtasia. Note that I treat this noise removal as an extra second layer, as it is a general noise frequencies remover. So yeah, removals, and not as fine-tuned as Audacity, so that's good. And this one's just a general overall background noise. And sometimes I feel I need just to add a tiny bit extra noise removal with Audacity. Also, the volume has a limit of only 250% increase. So if the volume is still too low, I would go and maybe increase it a bit more. But the volume max is 250 increase there. So, and then I usually share slash export to the following MP4 only, up to 1080 pixels. Interesting, pixels is the vertical number of pixels on the screen. It's interesting. Settings. Yeah, so here is the setting when I go export it. MP4 only up to 1080p. And that seems good enough for my YouTube videos. So let's just go here. And there's the Camtasia. I'm going to go and throw the two audio files that we have made. So I'm going to throw this inside. This is Pythagorean theorem. Just import it there, like that. And what I'm going to do is right click here, separate audio and video. I'm going to make the zoom smaller so we can see it, or just a bit bigger, like that. So you can see the sound forms or the waveforms there. I'm going to go and drag this in here. Remember, this one had the louder audio, like that. I'm going to press play. You see.
It's another.
Yeah, so it plays both at the same time. Let's see how it is without the audio removal and audio increase.
Not the easy solution. Today we're going to discuss the Pythagorean.
So yeah, it has that background noise, and its volume's not high enough. Let's click this.
Theorem and do a simple proof of it. Well, here's the Pythagorean theorem.
So yeah, so it just sounds much better. So yeah, sometimes I would go and add this if you feel the need. This has, just throw it in here. This is general noise removal. So here's our default is 20.
Right angle triangle, which means this.
Yeah, but sometimes the audio is a bit squeaky. Let's see.
Draw a square, but the.
Anyways, this should be fine. Just put a 5.
Tilt it. So we'll.
So yes, you could play around with it. You could increase the volume. But yes, you could. I recommend sometimes. Yeah, sometimes just adding a tiny noise removal. If it makes the audio seem a bit better. Anyways, then you would go and share a local file, then go to MP4 only. Sometimes I press a smart player, but I usually don't want that. So just put this here. Click next. Organize subfolder. Nope. Just put this audio fixed. All right. So yes, and then it takes a decent amount of time to fully finish this. I'm just going to pause and then come back when it's almost done. All right, yes, yeah, so I skipped it over here. So it's almost done rendering, and it's going to auto-play this. I have it set to auto-play. So it's going to auto-play. Let's see how it is. Almost done. Just a few more seconds. All right. All right, so finish.
It's another math easy solution.
That's pretty good audio outside of that random abrupt noise initially.
Today we're going to discuss plus b. Okay, so let's get it there. Squared, which equals, so it'll be a times.
Yes, yeah, I'm not sure what program I was using there. Some sort of a notepad or something. I'm not sure what this was. It wasn't Microsoft Word. Because I used to use Microsoft Word, then I switched to Microsoft OneNote. But this one, I believe, was something else. All right. So, yes.
2AB plus C squared.
So yes, that sound looks pretty good there. So, let's go back here. So, yes, hope this, that's all for today. I hope this tutorial helps. Had I seen this exact tutorial 2 months ago, I would have saved dozens of hours of trial and error audio editing. That's a good learning experience. Anyways, all for today. Like always, so I hope you enjoyed this one. And try it out for yourself. Hopefully it helps. And like always, you can download these exact notes in the link below, as well as viewing these notes. I'll put this in article format on Steemit. So check me out over there. The link will be in the description below. Anyways, thanks for watching and stay tuned for another Math Easy Solution.